Hi, my name is Johnny Vaught, and this is The Review, where I review the latest and the greatest movies. This week, I'm going to be talking about the latest iteration of A Star Is Born. Before we get to that, just a little bit about me and the show. Here at The Review, I will always offer my recommended viewing guide. I will recommend that you go and see it, stay home and stream it, or skip it. Now, I certainly have always been a fan of a music biopic, whether real or fictional, and I went into A Star Is Born certainly looking to love it, and I absolutely came away from it knowing that I had just experienced and got to see something special. I loved this movie. It is rated R. There is adult content, certainly rated R for content as well as themes. It's an adult story. The characters in them are adults, and I do think that it is something that with the test of time will stand up amongst other adult classic music biopics. I thought that this one gets to live in the canon of Walk the Line. Definitely, it's right up there with that. And that being said, this is the fourth iteration of A Star Is Born. There has been a version of this story told on film in 1937, 1954, and 1976. It has been a while since the last one, and I have not seen all of those movies all the way through. But I did see this movie, I did love this movie, and I think that you will too. Now, there's a lot of press about this movie, so I think that some of us might be more familiar with some aspects of it other than other parts. And my favorite part of this movie absolutely was Lady Gaga's performance. One of the things that I'm worried about happening in the next couple weeks is I think that people will begin to discredit this performance because it is relatively similar to the character that Lady Gaga plays for all of us all the time as a pop star for the world to see. I do not think that this performance is in any way something that should be viewed as lesser because it's portrayed by someone who lives a life similar to her character. She was performing the whole time, and I did think that Lady Gaga's performance as Ally was incredibly notable. Certainly incredibly powerful. The songs that she performed were bangers and absolutely awesome. I cannot say enough good things about the soundtrack for this movie. It's available for you right now, streaming. Definitely treat yourself. Listen to it. Some of these original songs are gifts to humanity, like Beatles songs. They are songs that did not exist before, and they do now. We live in a world where they do. Treat yourself. I loved this movie. Bradley Cooper directed it. It was his first time directing a movie. That isn't to say that it was his first rodeo, though. He has been in so many movies. He certainly has opinions that he was able to express. I did think that it was cool that this movie didn't look by the numbers necessarily. I thought that some shots were framed in interesting and cool ways. There were vast, wide open spaces portrayed as well as small, intimate scenes. I thought that it was a flex-worthy performance that I do hope he sees some recognition from the awards in the next couple months for his direction as well as his performance in the movie as Jackson Maine, which I also thought was super cool. Just a little background about his character. He is more famous at the start of the story, gets introduced to Lady Gaga's character Ally, and then the story takes off from there. Bradley Cooper played his own instruments. He was taught how to do that by Willie Nelson's son for this, which I just think is super cool to like acquaint yourself with such greatness to prepare for a part. It was clear that he had put in the work, and the performances that he gave seemed very true and real, and his voice is on par with rock stars. Good for Bradley Cooper. He can do no wrong, and he has such a cool haircut in this movie. I am a hairstylist, and I certainly get myself distracted watching movies sometimes with notable haircuts, and Bradley Cooper is an excellent example for any man looking to wear their hair longer without it getting long. Super great. I thought that this movie was an absolute roller coaster of emotion in a great way. The ebbs and flows and the highs and lows of this movie were truly a ride. It runs 2 hours and 16 minutes. It never drags at all. I can't say enough good things about it. And one of the things that I've noticed is that many people also have a lot to say about this movie. I am going to recommend that you go and see it And not because I necessarily think that you need to see this movie on a huge screen to enjoy it as much as I do think that it benefits from a large screen. I'm saying go and see it because so many people have seen it that you have an opportunity to be part of a community and talk about a really cool thing. Treat yourself, go and see it, go to work, talk about it. Anywhere that you go, any community that you're in, encourage other people to see this movie because it's valid, first of all. And also, it's such cool art. It looks great, it sounds great, the performances are tip top. I mentioned his hair. Her hair is awesome. Sam Elliott's in this movie. He's a national treasure. So I would say definitely treat yourself to it. And when you do, just buckle up and get ready for the last song that Lady Gaga sings. It's incredible. And she performed it just moments after one of her true closest friends had passed away. She had thought about not performing the song right then and taking a day. She didn't. And it is powerful. A Star Is Born, strong. Loved it. Go and see it. Treat yourself. It's urgent. Go and see A Star Is Born. My name is Johnny Vaught, and this has been The Review.